Hi, I'm Kirsty McKean from Naio Nails. In this video, we're going to talk about 2016. I'm going to tell you my favourite videos and we're going to show you some of the videos that got the most views. So excited. 2016 has been an awesome year. I'm quite sad to say goodbye to 2016, but I'm definitely looking forward to 2017 because we have done so well on this channel and it's only because of your views. And I'm going to show you some of the videos that have had the top views, they've had the most thumbs up, and some of them are just the ones that I generally really enjoyed doing. These are in no particular order. There is not a first, second and third place to these videos. They are just in any old order. Towards the end of 2016, it's been all about chrome, and everybody's definitely gone crazy for holochrome, for the holographic chrome. Oh my God, you know, it's that beautiful color that unicorns are made of. Oh look, I have it on my nails even now. I absolutely love it, everybody loves it. One of my favorite videos was the holographic chrome bow on a stiletto nail. Because I love bows and I got really excited that I could make a bow and then I could make it chrome and holographic all at the same time. Who wouldn't want that? Absolutely loved it. Loved doing it. I wish I could wear them that long. I get really jealous when I do really long, beautiful nails on these models of mine and they walk away with these amazing nails and I sit here with just the average length nail.
Yeah, but everyone always loves your nails.
Do you know what? I think I need to have really long nails again.
Just for a week or something?
Just for a week or something, just to treat myself. Yeah, 2017. That's what I've got to do, start wearing long nails. So there were the kids ones. I call them the kids ones. They are the kids editions. There was two. Well, there's three actually. There was the bloopers one. There was part one.
I could have done two bloopers ones. There was that many in it.
Yeah, there was part one, which was Alicia doing my nails. And Cassidy did the part two doing my nails. And they were both so fantastic, considering that they've never done anything like this before. I thought they were fabulous on camera. You know, they were just themselves, so they were just exactly how they are at home. A little bit crazy, come out with funny comments and everything like that. I loved the fact that they could see what I do. And from them having that experience, Alicia now wants to be a YouTuber. So that's going to be a career. So I don't know if this is a good thing or a bad thing. I wanted to be like a doctor or a lawyer or something like that, you know, or a brain surgeon. But no, she wants to be a YouTuber. Okay, maybe I'll have to make those dreams come true.
What did Zero say to Eight?
I don't know, what did Zero say to Eight?
Nice belt.
I like the shots where you can see me and the kids in the background on the screen, because you can see my face being a little bit like, and you can see them really having so much fun and making a mess a little bit. And me getting a little bit frustrated because I wanted everything neat and perfect.
I'm sorry, I'm going to put in there because they made less mess than you did.
Yeah, I just mean like generally making, listen, I don't mind my mess, me making a mess on the table because I'm working so quick, but everybody else's mess really like, you can't cope.
What do you call cheese that's not yours?
Not my cheese.
No, not your cheese.
And then, oh my God, the long Alice in Wonderland whole experience was absolutely amazing. I loved the end result. It took what felt like an age to do because there was so much in there, but I wanted to do this because I wanted everybody to see what somebody who's doing a competition that's, you know, that type of competition, a boxed art competition, I wanted you all to see what preparation goes into it and There's so much involved and it took a long time, but I absolutely loved it and I hope you loved it too.
Do you know what I want to say about that?
What?
I hated editing those videos.
You hated it. You hated editing that, Al.
It was 32 hours worth of footage.
32 hours?
Yeah, 32 hours worth of footage, yeah.
What's that over 8 hours? Is it 4 days? I think about 4 days, I think it was.
There was 5 days of filming.
5 days of filming?
Yeah, with about six hours in each one.
Can we do another one?
No! Yes, yes, we can do another one, but I am prepping it this time.
Okay. What, are you prepping the nails?
No.
There's a video that I kind of forgot about, which was the how to sculpt long acrylic stiletto nails. I think I forgot about it because I kind of do that quite a lot. And this is just a video about how to do that nail, about the structure, how to sculpt it out. And maybe because it's got no art on and everything like that, maybe that's why I forgot about it. However, it's my most viewed tutorial. It's had 2,566,398 views so far. By the time you watch this video, it's probably had more. Wow, that is just amazing. Something so simple can have so many millions of views. It's amazing, thank you guys. This video was definitely a highlight for 2016. Polish Mountain! Oh my God. That's another long video. It was a long video.
It
was so monotonous. It was just layer after layer after layer. So we got to 200 and whatever it was, layers. You know, I'd begun to lose the will to live. However, we saw lots of pretty gel polishes.
We did, a lot of red gel polishes.
A lot of red ones, ooh, and we created this nice little tower out of gel polish.
It's cool. I mean, our videos, out of all of the Polish Mountain videos, ours has got quite a lot of views.
Yeah.
Compared to a lot of the others, it was good fun. Even though it was a hard slog.
Yeah. Do you know what? We can laugh about it now.
Yeah, because we've done it.
Yes.
should we
do it again?
No.
Never going back to Polish Mountain.
This is when I found out you had a good singing voice.
Oh, because I started singing the different names at the Polish.
Yeah, and so you sang the same name.
Not too bad at singing, you know, don't you know?
It's the only thing that kept us awake.
I know, well, yeah. Yeah, we started getting a little bit crazy at certain points, but yeah, we can laugh about it now. To be wild. Oh, is this one named after me? Born to be wild. You're the one. You're the one I want. You are the one I want. Ooh, ooh, ooh. So thank you for, we've had 1,342,458 million views. Did I say that right?
Something like that.
Something like that.
There's a lot of views.
Over
across the two videos.
Over 1.3 million videos. And that is just on part one. And there was two parts. So thank you very much for watching. I actually watched this the other day. I don't normally watch myself, to be honest with you, because I don't like the sound of my own voice. In my head I sound fine, but on camera I just sound a bit weird. This video is called Easy Guide How to Safely Remove Acrylic Nails. And I went through some of the comments and I could see how like some people were saying, oh, I go to this place and they get a tip and they shove it behind the nail and sort of wrench it off. And I could see that people going, oh my God, you should never go back to that salon. I saw that people had put the how beautiful the nails were underneath because it had been done correctly. I also saw that somebody put about ping, there goes the nail hitting somebody in the eye.
I did need a crash helmet.
Now listen, I know that they were flying everywhere, but I thought it was quite funny. For safety first, you can hold the end of the nail so it doesn't go flying. You know, that's quite simple to do. It doesn't need a brain surgeon to work out that you just hold the end of the nail whilst cutting it and it won't fling everywhere. But we just thought that was quite
funny.
That was
just a total by chance episode, that as well, because we were doing Faye's nails and I was like, right, should we do a video of taking them off? Because they were massive.
Yeah.
They were like 4 inches, I think.
They were big nails. Big nails, and they take a long time to come off, but I showed you how to take them off very quickly and very safely. preserving that beautiful natural nail. Another popular video was the quilted gel nail design, which is like a Chesterfield kind of cushioned look. I've seen wallpaper like this as well. But we did this 3D on a nail. It's really wearable. It's something that's, you know, not too long. You can do it on a really long nail if you want to, but we did it on a really wearable size nail, and it's a really wearable nail design, and also very effective because it's so simple to do. If you haven't checked that video out, you need to do that because it's not as hard as it actually looks.
I disagree with you there. That looks so hard to do.
Do you think?
Yeah, because this is when I realised that, not that I didn't know that you were a great artist before that, but seeing you do that, and each segment is exactly the same size and perfectly spaced and like symmetrically spaced. It just...
Yeah, it does have to be, I suppose, yeah, some people might find that harder.
Really, I just went, how the hell did you manage to do that? I watched you do it in front of my eyes and it was just, wow. Totally shocked by you.
Yeah, see, because maybe I just think it's quite easy because it is the same shape.
Yeah.
But obviously, yes, you do have to have the spacing correct and everything to be symmetrical. It looks ridiculous. If you get the spacing wrong on one of those diamond shapes, it throws the whole design off.
Yeah, completely.
But when you start from the middle and work out, you know, that's how you do it. If you started from one corner and graduated, you'd just mess it up. You've got to start from the middle and work your way out. I've only found this by doing this design, you know, a number of times. The aluminium, hold on, I can't say it again. Aluminium.
Well done.
Or aluminum. Crinkle gel nail. Do you know what? That. I did something like this years and years and years ago when I competed in Finland, and I did it out of acrylic, and there was no such thing as these liquid sort of metal gels or about then. There was no chrome or anything like that. And I did it with acrylic to make texture on one of the designs that I did. And I just, you know, these kind of things come up just by chance and playing with the product. So I just thought, well, can you do it with gel?
I called this the sandwich bag nail, didn't I?
Oh yeah, the sandwich bag nail. Because obviously I had the idea to do it. Oh, I did this cool thing like years ago. Oh, we'll do it with gel. Because I just thought, oh, we've got this new product. This is aluminium, liquid aluminium product. And thought, oh, can we do that with gel? Blah, blah, blah. And I was like, I need like some really thin plastic to do this design. It was like, oh, what have you got? What have we got? Oh, sandwich bag. We use a sandwich bag. That'll work.
And it did.
And it worked. Before, I actually used a carrier bag.
Yeah.
Yeah, like a really, it's a thin, you know, cheap carrier bags that you get from cheap places.
And that one's got a lot of use as well for such a simple thing, but it looks so cool.
Yeah, it's got 229,000 views just for some, it's quite simple. Anybody can do that.
Yeah.
Even you can do that, Adam. Oh my God. One highlight as well from 2016 is the My Little Pony phenomenon. Everybody went a bit crazy for My Little Ponies, so I decided to do My Little Pony nails. We did them hand painted, we did 3D, and the Twilight Sparkle nail, oh my God, 894,000 views, you know, close to 1 million views just off one Twilight Sparkle. Who knew that Twilight Sparkle was the most popular one? I didn't. I thought it was Rainbow Dash. So yeah, we did a series of these. We did a few, you know, how many My Little Ponies did
we
do?
Because we did three on shorter nails, and then we did three on longer stilettos.
Yeah, I enjoyed doing them though. My kids loved them.
Yeah, was it? I thought they were brilliant.
Oh, I still don't own a pair of these.
If Christine Louboutin is a Louboutin.
If Christine Louboutin is watching, please, will you send me a pair of these shoes? Because I still don't have a pair. But we did an amazing nail that showed you a simple way to do the Louboutin manicure. You know what? I do need to be wearing these. I will only, do you know what? I'll only wear these nails when I have a pair of these shoes.
I loved all those nails because they were really
nice. Are you listening, Griff? I hope you're listening.
Christmas soon.
Christmas is coming. This girl needs some shoes. You better look after me, boy.
I did like this series because it was very simple.
Yeah, simple
and
but
really elegant.
Classy.
And classy.
Just,
and wasn't
just like
much,
me.
Oh my god.
Yeah, but this is, I don't know, I mean, really, really popular series. Absolutely went a bit berserk, which was absolutely amazing. Because I think it is due to the fact that it is so wearable. Mm. Definitely really wearable. How to sculpt an acrylic and glitter butterfly nail tutorial. Oh my god, Facebook. Oh my god, Facebook went berserk for this. Everybody was recreating the design, tagging me in it. I got so many notifications from people recreating the look. Everybody loved it, and I'm so glad that it inspired everybody. And I know what it did do, because a lot of people messaged me. It pushed people to their limits, and they got so much enjoyment out of it, and it really pushed their skills. And that is what it's about. Because you will never become a better nail technician if you sit there at home or in the salon producing the same thing day in, day out. You've got to push yourself to your limits to get better. And this tutorial definitely did that for a lot of people. It's got a lot of views, it's got 405,000 views, which is pretty cool. But oh my God, my hair! My hair's just like it's like an ash blondie colour. No, it's not. It's not even. No, some of it's ash, some of it's pink, some of it's purple. There's all feathers going on. There's loads and loads of feathers. I do like my hair there. Oh my god, this has got no hair extensions in. Oh my god, in this video I have no hair. Feel like I have no hair. I have got baby pink natural hair. No hair extensions. The video is how to create an acrylic 3D ice cream cone. Absolutely loved this. We did a few of these different ways. I really loved it. Again, Facebook went a bit berserk with this as well, and loads of people recreated them. I think this was easier to recreate than maybe like the butterfly nail. Such a cute design, and we did this at summertime, which was perfect. But my hair? Oh my god, my hair! I think I look better with hair extensions. I definitely think so. Oh, the beginning of this one. This is 3D acrylic nail art apples. The beginning. I totally mess it up and I go. My hair again is different here. It's like my lilac look when I was having my lilac look. So for this video, I remember Adam going, oh my god, I can't believe that bead of acrylic that looks like an apple. How the hell did you do that? And it's so simple. So, so simple to do. Really enjoyed doing these fruity ones. Because we did a couple of them. We did the apple ones, we did the grapes, and we also did the strawberries. Really enjoyed it. It was something a little bit different. And they got quite good views as well. But this is like one of my favourite ones. How to sculpt a scallop. Nail. I have done this nail quite a few times. I do love doing it because I like doing really long nails, and this looks better on really long nails. And Faye, who was the model for this, has had this shape quite a few times because she loves it. And I really enjoy doing something a little bit different. So there you are, that's why I love this video. Nail terminology. Nail terminology for beginners and students. Oh my god, love this, because I love to explain and teach. I like people to actually understand what the hell I'm talking about. Sometimes you might watch my videos and think, well, I don't know what that means. This was the perfect video for those people. You could just watch it and know exactly what these words I'm using are. They are English, but they mean things. Yes, they have meanings.
This was the first time on camera where you kind of came out your shelf.
Yeah.
It was the first time you filmed you, apart from intros.
Ah.
And it was the first time that you kind of like had to talk to camera and you came
be
out
me.
Of your shell.
I
yeah,
could be me.
You. Yeah.
Yeah. Because we definitely think that this channel has evolved. over time. And I've been more me on camera because I'm quite animated,
extrovert
and animated, and I don't want to just sit there like this and teach you how to do nails and talk really normally and like, hello, my name is Kirsty Meakin from Naio Nails and I am going to show you how to sculpt a stiletto nail. First of all, we're going to prep the nail, and then we're going to do this, and then we're going to do that. How boring would that be? Bye-bye to the boring people. Hello to the crazy people. Pink and blue fade with 3D flowers. Oh my God, Jackie loved these nails, you know. Yeah, Jackie was the model for this, and she loved them. She got loads of attention. They weren't extremely long. I would say, definitely say that they were wearable. It had quite a large flower on there, and I loved doing the different coloured petals going round to create this, you know, this big 3D flower. It was the first time we'd done the different coloured petals on film, and I really enjoyed doing that. I got quite a lot of views as well. We did a series of videos called Extreme Nail Acrylic and Gel Polish Design. They are the ones with the sort of white and nude, and they've got studs on them and chains hanging off them, and they were beautiful. They got a whole heap of views, more than we ever thought that they would, because they were a little bit more unusual than we were doing at that time, but they definitely were loved by you all.
They were the first set of crazy nails that I ever edited.
Yeah.
Like, and I was like, what the people wear them? How can you do that? There was chains going between them and all sorts, wasn't it?
So the competition nail that we did, I did that on my model that I use for competitions. So whenever I do pink and white competitions, I use Adele because she's got super long, skinny fingers. Her nail beds are so long, they're just beautiful. I'm sure she just sits at home all day rubbing oil into her fingers to get them that nice. But no, she doesn't really. She's just born with kick-ass nails. So yeah, I use her, and it was the first time I had done on film, actually. I say film? Do we use film anymore?
No, on video.
The first time I've done a video of competition nails, and I loved it, and I love sharing it with you. It's got a lot of views. It's got 830,000 views. A lot of views. Nearly a million. Then there was the salon style almond nail that we sculpted out. This was so wearable. Everybody loved this video. We had some really great comments. We had lots of thumbs up. I think people do like to watch something that is simple as well as watching the crazy stuff. Oh, and then there was the battle that commenced from DC and Marvel. I loved doing these nails. I loved doing the Spider-Man. Oh. Spider-Man, Spider-Man, does whatever Spider can. I like doing like the intricate stuff. I like to do like the Suicide Squad nails, all that, you know, really detailed paintwork. I really enjoyed doing them. I think doing hand-painted work is probably my favourite thing on this channel. So anything that's hand painted, I love. I get excited about it. And if it's got a bit of bling on it as well, that's, you know, a must, definitely. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed our top 20 for 2016. It's been a fantastic year. Thank you so much for watching and giving us thumbs up and subscribing and all that. You've been absolutely amazing. Bring on 2017. What's next?
Adam does Kirsty's nails.
Oh my God. Hell to the no. Okay. Got this feeling in my body. Can't stop the feeling.